Hi students,
I am Ramesh, Assistant Professor, Department of ECE, Sri Ishwar College of Engineering. In this video, I am going to explain you about Arduino interfacing with digital sensor and digital actuator. So here, digital sensor is PIR sensor, digital actuator is LED. Both are going to be interfaced with Arduino Uno. The logic what we are going to develop is when a living thing in the visibility of PIR sensor, it is going to give logic 1 to Arduino Uno. When Arduino Uno senses logic 1, it is going to switch on or actuate LED. When a living thing is out of the visibility of PIR sensor is going to give logic 0 to Arduino Uno. Based on the logic, Arduino Uno is going to switch off this LED. So this is what the task we are going to do in this video. So for this, we are going to use an online tool called Tinkercad. So just Google it, Tinkercad. Use the first link. This is free online tool. Can utilize with the help of your Google account itself. So I already have account. So if you are the first time user, you need to use with the help of this create personal account. By using any one of your Google account or any one of your account, you can get your login credential. I have already have account in Tinkercad. So I am going to just sign in. So sign in with Google. So Tinkercad is powered by Autodesk. So this is what my user credential to Tinkercad. So it is entering. So now the screen move to this page. In this page, we are going to select circuits. In this, we are going to create a new circuit. Select create new circuit. So our objective is to interface PIR sensor and LED to Arduino Uno. For that, first we are going to select Arduino Uno. So we are going to just type basic Arduino. Arduino. So we have Arduino. This is Arduino Uno. Just we are going to drag and drop it. This is Arduino Uno. Here this is going to be interfaced with PIR sensor. PIR sensor. Select. Sensor and then LED. So it is LED available. LED and LED needs to be connected with a resistor. So to I am going to utilize pin number 12 to anode of LED. And cathode of LED is going to be grounded. Next, PIR sensor has 3 pins. One is ground, another one is power. Third one is signal, from where we are getting digital output. So ground is going to be connected with ground pin of Arduino Uno. Power pin is connected with 5 volt of Arduino Uno. Signal pin is going to be connected with any one of the digital pins as we knew. Pin number 0 to 13, all are digital input output pins. So I am going to connect it with pin number 4. You can connect any one of the pins out of these 13 pins. Oh, sorry, 14 pins. So this is what the circuit connection. I'm going to change the location. Next I'm moving into coding part. So in coding part, I'm going to select. So for this, how to go? So if you click code, you'll get this window. In this, you choose this drop down, you'll get text. Then give continue to start your coding. The PD pin coding is available. So here, setup has been used. Setup. This is the segment, code segment for doing configuration. Loop. This is the code segment for doing tasks. So here the configuration is PA sensor is connected with 4 pin of Arduino. LED is connected with 12 pin of Arduino. So we need to configure these two pins. That is pin mode. With the help of pin mode function, we can configure the pins of Arduino Uno. So now I am trying to configure pin number 4 as input pin because it is connected with sensor. Arduino is taking input from the sensor, PA sensor. So 12th pin is connected with LED. So 12th pin needs to be output pin. Already we have code, so just we need to alter this pin mode of 12 comma output. Now with these two functions or statements, pin number 4 is acting as input pin for Arduino Uno, pin number 12 is acting as output pin for Arduino Uno. Next we are moving into the logic. We have PDPin code, we try to modify that. So, our setup we can develop our code, not an issue. We'll develop. So, our objective is when PA sensor gives logic 1, it is the Arduino Uno needs to write logic 1, then only LED will glow. So, how to read PA sensor? If we read the value from pin number 4, that 2 digital value from pin number 4, that is going to the control variable for the program. So how to read pin number 4? This is actually pin number 4 is connected with PIR sensor. PIR sensor is a digital sensor. So we are going to use the prediction function called digital read. Arduino is reading. So we are giving digital read of pin number 4. So if we give, this function is going to return either 1 or 0, logic high or low. To catch that, you need to create a variable integer a equal to digital read of. Now, based on the value of A, we need to activate LED. So, with the help of simple if loop, we are going to develop the code. So, when if A equal to 1, if A equal to 1, what is the function we need to do? That is, if A equal to 1 in the sense, now PA sensor, a person or a living thing is in the visibility of PA sensor. At the time what should happen? LED should glow. So for that we need to glow. That is, LED needs to be switched on. LED can be switched on by giving logic high to 12 pin. और we are going to do digital write off digital write off 12 comma 5. So to visualize the output, we are giving a time delay of 1 second. Delay of some 1 second. In the else part, that is, if it is not 1, what is required? LED needs to be switched off. So again, this pin needs to be 12th pin needs to be given as logic low. So same code I am just copying. Digital write off 12, 5. So this is what the logic. So here it needs to be changed, that is low. Why? Because when the person in the visibility of PIR sensor, it needs to switch on LED. When the person is out of range, LED needs to be switched off. So that is what our program. Let me check by simulating this. How to simulate? With the help of this button called start simulation. So when I press start simulation, start simulating. I need to click. Before that, I need to minimize the size of the circuit. Okay, now person is in the visibility of PIR sensor, so LED is in on state. He should be in the visibility, and also he should be in the movement, because it is also a motion sensor. So now the person is in the visible range, so LED is in on state. Now the person is out of range, LED is in off state. Even if the person is moving in and around of the visibility of PIR sensor, LED will be in off state. But when the person is inside and he should be in the movement, LED will be in on state. And so this is what the operation of Arduino interfacing with digital sensor and digital actuator. Thank you for watching.